God's word is clothed in truth and righteousness. We are his children, and with our heart we do confess. With our heart we do confess. Guess what? Good morning, Dorothy Patterson. Good morning, Paula. You on? Deuteronomy 28. Now it shall come to pass, if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe carefully all his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above the nations of the earth, and all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall be the fruit of your body, the produce of your ground, and the increase of your herds, the increase of your cattle, and the offspring of your flocks. Blessed shall be your basket and your kneading bowl. Blessed shall you be when you come in. Blessed shall you be when you go out. Blessed the Lord will cause your enemies who rise against you to be defeated before your face. They shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways. The Lord will command the blessing on you in your storehouses and in all to which you set your hand. And he will bless you in the land which the Lord God is giving you. The Lord will establish you as a holy people to himself, just as he has sworn to you. If you keep the commandments of the Lord your God and walk in his ways, then all the peoples of the earth shall see that you are called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of you. And the Lord will grant you plenty of goods in the fruit of your body, in the increase of your livestock, and in the produce of your ground, in the land of which the Lord swore to your fathers to give you. The Lord will open to you his good treasure, the heavens, to give the rain to your land in its season and to bless all the work of your hand. You shall lend to many nations, but you shall not borrow. And the Lord will make you the head and not the tail. You shall be above only and not beneath. If you heed the commandments of the Lord your God, which I command you today, and be careful to observe them, so you shall not turn aside from any of the words which I command you this day to the right or the left, to go after the gods to serve them. This is the word of the Lord. We honor it by saying thanks be to God. Deuteronomy 28, when Moses was talking to the Israelites, the second generation Israelites that were in the wilderness, that he was advising, he was instructing them, exhorting them to be obedient. A very good morning to everybody who is on here. A very good morning to our leadership, Pastor Linval Earl Lewis, First Lady Sister Anne-Marie Lewis, all the deacons, the deaconesses, all my peeps from Greater Portmore Tabernacle, Spanish Town Tabernacle, Kingston Tabernacle, all you who are near and far, who are watching from all over the world, here in Jamaica and outside. We thank you, friends, well-wishers, for joining us this morning, this week. The theme has been different. It's a different theme from different speakers this week, and this morning, it's no different. This morning, I began with the word of God in Deuteronomy 28, all the blessings, and been singing, we are blessed, because if you say it and speak it long enough and believe it deep enough, it will manifest. We are blessed. So, can we count our blessings this morning? Come, let's count our blessings today. It's an invitation, an open invitation right now, wherever you are. Count our blessing. Let's count our blessing. You know, I went to get some fruits at the fruit stand some time ago, right? And I was there ordering my fruits. When I arrived to buy the fruits, there was somebody else in front of me, so I had to join the line and wait and park up. And it's a place I go often. Now, the person who was before me, he was ordering and, you know, he saw me and we struck up a conversation because he's a man of God. So we were talking and he was just congratulating, encouraging me. He was telling me that I made a good move because it was early in my conversion. I made a good move, you know, and he was just giving me good godly counsel and telling me about the centrality of the word of God. And it was good conversation. So we talk and we laugh together and thing, and, you know, then get him fruits and him leave. Then I go up now for order my fruits. And when I order fruits, you know, I order a good portion, not just to eat right there. I take it home, I put it up in the fridge so I can blend each man, I order a good portion. So my order, and it was packaged and thing, and I got ready to pay the fruits man. I'm so, what you do? I'm so, what? I'm so, no man, it pay for man. I'm so, what? I'm so, it pay for the man that was here, him pay for your fruits. I said, I was puzzled because it's not like he said to me that I'll take care of fruits. He just like an angel, just paid for the food, said nothing to me, laughed, talked with me, and left. I could even thank him because he wasn't there for me to say, thank you, man. He just paid for my fruits and left. So I was there with the money in my hand. And the man said, go on, man, you're blessed. I don't remember if that was the exact word, but that's how I felt in the moment. You're blessed. So the truth is, can we count our blessings? You know, you have heard this phrase so often, count your blessings. It's like it's a platitude. You know, it's cliche almost. Count your blessings. But how often do you do it? When last you stop, really stop and count your blessings? Do you pause to feel grateful when something good happens? Especially for those who are living in Jamaica right now. This is Thursday and we're heading into a weekend of lockdown because last year March and this year March, it's like they are alike in terms of what is happening in the space, in the health sector, what's happening with this pandemic. It's increasing again and it's stressing for a number of people. My wife Karen just shared me a conversation with her and a close friend who was saying she wasn't taking this COVID thing serious because, you know, people don't want to talk about that until her friend Fisher went into the COVID-19 ward, stricken with the disease, the illness, that thing, that terrible thing, stricken, and he was on the COVID-19 ward. He said, on that ward, the light is constantly on, so he doesn't know night or day. The doctor who's assigned, the nurse, comes to him only once per day. After that, they monitor him on some cameras. They don't see him. And the ward is desolate, empty, empty. When that one nurse comes to him, she's closed. So he said the feeling, the experience is like he described as is. As if you're drowning and you just come up top of the water, just to catch water and go back down. That's the feeling he described. That's like you're drowning and you're trying to gasp for air. They had him on a ventilator. He was there having conversations with friends, you know what I mean? But not friends, but other patients. And he said, all he heard on the wall was, Jesus, Jesus, save me now. Have mercy, have mercy. The morning, next morning, he was talking to a friend the night. He was just crying out, Jerry. And, you know, the morning, he said, wake up. He didn't even know if I'm morning. He just wake up. And he said, Jerry. One of the nurse said, Jerry dead last night, you know. The same Jerry, he was having a conversation, was crying out, Jesus, Jesus. He said, right now, he can't have a good church. Man said, he can't even go to church because when he hear people that said Jesus, he get traumatized. He was so traumatized, they had to put him on ward 21. You know, because it was personal to her and she was describing the experience to Karen and thing, and I heard it and thing. We don't know. We don't accept it until it comes close home, until you're afflicted. No, because we see all these people with asymptomatic symptoms and asymptomatic experiences, and we say, oh, it's okay, I may not be affected. You never know. So we are here this morning, on this life, this Thursday morning, we are breathing the breath of life, and I'm inviting you to count your blessings. Maybe a simple thing. Some people try to write a gratitude journal, right? Why, by the recording the things that they are grateful for and in the evening before they go to bed. But it's kind of hard in the evening because sometimes you're tired, you don't want to write anything down. But today, I'm going to give you three simple ways to count your blessings. And I'm inviting you, start thinking about all the blessings, the simple little things, because we're going to type them here. Today, we're going to count our blessings together because we're giving thanks for every single thing. We're giving thanks that we are right here now, sharing this space together. First thing, jot it down. Note your blessings all through the day. You know, you can keep a small notebook with a pen or a pencil in your pocket or your bag or even in your car. Or use your phone. You can write on your phone. Or you can voice note on your phone. That's a quick note, you know, to record something that's positive that happens to you. You know, it don't have to be anything major, you know. So for example, all right, let me give you an example. You're coming out of the supermarket. Rain starts falling suddenly, heavily. You're trying to head to either the taxi stand or the bus stop or your car to go home, and you can't move because you don't have an umbrella. Somebody come with an umbrella and just escort you in their umbrella. Those simple things. And you just feel blessed, right? Just write it down and say, I feel blessed that somebody come, you know what I mean? Maybe rushing to get back somewhere and they were just on time. Just write that down, you know what I mean? Or somebody compliment what you're wearing. Write it down. Somebody compliment your blouse or your pants or your shirt, man or woman. Just write it, jot it down or make a note about it. Yesterday, my wife, right? Real time. She went to the store, and I keep saying, go early, you know, because the rush is coming on, get little stuff and things so we can, you know. And when she went there, the store was empty. Supermarket was empty, the place, you know. And she felt so good. She said, all right, she can go in and get her stuff now. And she go in to get her stuff. And I tell her, by the time she was in there, the place was overwhelmed with people, the parking lot full immediately. She went there just in time to get through, to beat this rush. I know Jamaican states, like when hurricane. So there's some simple things, just could have noted that down. So the first thing, jot it down, make a note. The second thing, find something positive in difficult situation. This is the tough one. Find something positive, like now we're experiencing, find something positive in difficult situation. Use the same notebook. Every time you encounter a challenge or a seemingly negative situation, just find one single positive thing you can do about it and write it down. So for example, if you work somewhere and your boss, you know, always in a bad mood and stress you out, you could just write down, my boss does not determine my emotional mood. So you go so and take control of your mood. You know what I mean? Yes, Sister Irma, count your blessings, name them one by one. And when you name them, Sister Irma, you're going to have to type some of them this morning. Yes, we can't end this without we type some of the blessings them. But I'm saying, you're at the workplace and the boss has stressed you out. Just you decide that, look here, the boss, you won't determine my emotional state. And take control because it all happens in your mind. You know? You have control, you have choice. You know? All right, negative situation. All right, a police stop you, you drive. and police stop you and tell you that your license, the vehicle registration, the sticker, expire. You never check it, you never notice. Completely unaware. Let me tell you something. When your sticker expire right now, it costs $20,000 is the fine. Check it. $20,000. Right now, in this situation, that can feed so many households right now and groceries if we make sure so them can eat and find substance over this period we are coming here. Everybody are worried about because it's future. Fear is future, what's going to happen. So you don't want to can deal with them situation there. And then the police now said to you, say, all right, my Giablai, note that down. Note that down. Now make a note about it. Say it, make a note about it and think. You know what I mean? Just say, you're blessed. Finally, the last one. So the easiest one. Count your blessings. What that mean? Just get up a notebook. Don't write no words. Just write a stroke. Say every time something good happens, one stroke. Next something good happens, two. Three. Every time those strokes. At the end of the evening, count them. Say if you get like 12 strokes one day, then tomorrow now, you try to beat it. There, look here, there are so many things to give thanks for every single day. And let's start right now. Let's do it right now. I give thanks, I have a bottle of water, and I can own it with my hands like this. As simple as that, you know, I have to ask anybody. You ever mash a little finger yet? And you know, I've used feet, as simple as a little finger, and you suddenly realize how important your little finger is. So I can open this, and I can drink this. That's a blessing, just like that, you know. So Eulalie, she started grateful for the joy of family, biological and spiritual family, grateful to God's grace, Jesus atonement for my sins. Yes, gratitude. Dorona Edwards, my testimony. My spouse was tested positive for COVID-19, and myself and daughter's results was negative. That is a blessing, and he is doing much better now. That's a blessing. Let me do it this morning. Note it down. Pastor is saying, having my parents with me. Write it down. That's one. So if you are doing the third one, making marks, some people only have like about 2 marks. So there are much more. You know, I'm blessed that I can speak to you clearly using my mouth. There are people in the hospital right now who can't talk because they pushed things in their mouth. But we can talk. Just so I am blessed that I can talk to you this morning, that I am awake this morning. I am blessed because I woke up in my own bed. These are just every time you wake up in a bed, just give that's what I wake up in my own bed, not a hospital bed. My own in this situation, blessed, you know. Write it. I don't see people writing it down. No, write down your blessing. We're counting our blessings this morning. That way we can encourage each other. We can recognize the simple little things together. This is a count blessing day. This is the day we're going to be counting the blessing. I'll tell you something. If you're in any situation where it's a dry land situation, a desert situation, an empty situation, a down situation, where you are down and depressed, and these words can't even help you. I tell you something. If you trust in God, man, he'll make a way for you, man. Hear my wife saying, have a roof over our head. Yes, right now, if your roof now leak, right, if your roof now leak, when rain fall, you're blessed. Oh my God, when your roof leak, and you have set some pan or some different part of your house. Worse, when your roof leak in your bedroom, right over your bed. If you ever had I had that experience, my wife stressed out, and when your wife stressed, it's not a nice thing. You understand me, I tell you? So, Eulalie is saying, grateful for this ministry. You know, the simple things. Listen, we are going to come boldly to God this morning, counting our blessings, the little things. Sharon Sharif said, gratitude is a must. She's giving thanks for life. Today is my son's birthday. Happy birthday. What's his name, Sharon? Sharon Sharif, happy birthday, Sharon Sharif's son. So I'm giving thanks to God that my only child, right? She said, my only child, So she's celebrating his birthday. Maureen Dalhouse Holding, she said, I'm thankful for life. Yeah, some short listener, still, you know. Oh my God, man, you know, some short listener. having godly friends. That's a blessing. Having godly friends is a blessing, you know. Where you can share the word of God with them. You can talk about like things and you can pray with each other. You can imagine you have a godly friend, a Christian friend, where you pray for me and pray for you. Oh my God. That's a blessing. Diane Thompson, she don't put in her list yet. But listen, I heard a song, a new song, sung by our Jamaican gospel artist, Jeremy Edwards. The song was just released like about four days away. It's fresh. You might not even know it. You know, Veronica Brown Smacker said, even if it's leaking, you are still blessed because you could not have had a roof over your head. Yes, it's a Veronica. Yes, yes. I like that perspective. So if it's leaking, you still give thanks. You know what I mean? Listen, some people can only give thanks in good cheer when good things happen. But can you give thanks to the Lord? I hear a man of God say this morning. Can you give thanks to the Lord at a graveside of a relative? Can you give thanks to the Lord when you just get fired? Can you give thanks to the Lord when a family member is sick in the hospital? Can you give thanks in those situations? Listen, the God of the mountain is still the God in the valley, you know. You know, my wife is saying my family is alive and well. Yeah, to be surrounded by your family members where you can see them and you look at them and see they're up, that's a blessing, you know. We're writing them down this morning, man. We'll come back and watch this. Let it inspire people every single day to just count your blessing. If you can't write them down, just write a stroke. And at the end of the day, you count how much you get and next day you try for it. You know, because there are so many things to be blessed for. My wife said, I can prepare a meal today. Anybody here can prepare a meal today? If you can prepare a meal today, write down meal. Just say meal. If you can prepare a meal today, write down meal. Simone Dennis is saying, thank you, Lord, for the blessing of my renewed existence to see my family one more time this morning. And that even though she's saying, let me get this situation. Even though I am not working or is unable at times, the Lord has continued to bless my spouse and now my son to be working. Oh, mighty God, give thanks. Your spouse is working, providing for us. My son to be working, providing for us, even though many are going through a hard time. There's so much, but God is my provider. Yes, man, God is a provider. You have to give thanks to God, man. Hey, look here, man. When last you feel like just dance because you can dance. Where you have strength in your body, you just feel like that. You're just joyful for no reason at all. You're joyful because you realize that the breath of flow to your body. You realize that no matter what the situation is that come to you, you're not going to make it take control of your life. You look around, you find the simple things to focus on. Listen, let me tell you something. You see, when you start to focus on the simple things and make a number and make a note of it every day, the more you emphasize your blessing, the more you feel yourself genuinely grateful for every day of your life. I tell you, remember Psalm 84, now, you know, the word of God, it says, for a day in your courts, God's courts is better than 1,000. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wicked. 84:11, one of my favorite texts in Psalm 84. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold from those who walk uprightly. You have to say, Lord, you tell me, Lord, that no good thing will you withhold from those who walk uprightly. Forgive me, Lord. I seek you to walk, to please the Lord, and walk. And that is will that will manifest. Anything you speak over time, you start believing it manifests in your life. You only thank God for our family. A lot of people are thanking God for their family, especially in this time. You know, Veronica Brown said the simple things are our blessing. But simple things, write them down. Write the list right now. I give thanks for this Wi-Fi that you can see me and you can hear me. I give thanks. Oh my God, I feel like just celebrating this morning, man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're down right now, you don't have a job right now. I worry about this weekend. I worry about how you get food in your house. Who will call you? He'll make a way. He'll make a way. Some days high, some days low. I will not give up. I won't let go. I know God will make. You know, Sam, I sing that song in real time. You know what I got you. Eh? But we now focus on that. Trouble's on the left. I'm focusing on the blessings. Keep me in the focus. Me not busy with them, I say. I know God will make a way come. Why? God of the God of the valley, the mountain and the sea. I will not worry. God will make a way for me. Hey! Powerful and mighty. He provides all of my needs. I will believe through the storms. God will make a way for me. If you ever say that, I said, God, you'll make a way, you know. You're gonna make a way. You promise me, you know, God. Your promises are true. Sure. If you can part the sea for Moses, you can open doors for me. I know. God will make a way for me. Do you believe God will make a way for you? Eh? Father, you have never one failed me. Kept my family. Jesus fight for me. Jehovah Nissi. You remember Shabbat Meshach and Abednego? I feel like getting up and down this morning, man. This should be a Zoom call where I can't see we dance together. Man, are you dancing right now? I will not worry. Cause we, me not worry about this lockdown this weekend, you know. Me not worry about it, you know. Powerful and mighty God, me serve, you know, man. Him higher. He provide all my needs. Somebody gonna call you this morning. What you worrying about this morning? Somebody gonna call you. God is gonna cause a call to come to you this morning. And prove that He's God and He's good. He's God and He's good. Anyway, you plant me, that's where I'll go. I'm planted right here, giving thanks. When last you feel like dancing, just dance. Don't worry about it, just dance. Dance. David danced so much, his wife says that disgrace. He said, disgrace now? Disgrace now? And just dance in praise to God. I will not worry. This is how your turns are going to be this morning. People talk about turns, they are vengeance today. Lie. Lie. Focus out and focus in to the goodness of God. The song is called Make a Way. Brand new, 4 days old. Yeah. You will make a way. Thank you very much. Hey, yes, Simon Dennis, you're fighting big battles. Yes, right now. But I'm telling you, but guess what? Guess what? You said, guess what? You're expecting great things to come. Yes, man. Just hand the battle to God. He said, vengeance is mine. He said, the battle is the Lord. He'll make a way. Trust me. He'll make a way because His promises are true. His promises are sure. He will make a way for you. The God of the valley, the mountain and the sea. So I will not worry because He will make a way. That's how I'm coming out this morning on this song here. Maybe it's the first time you're hearing it. But if you don't remember anything at all, remember the hook, the punchline. God will make a way. Trust me. Some days I. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. I won't let go. I know, Lord, you will make a way for Simon Dennis right now. You will come true for her because you are good. You said your power is made manifest in our weakness. I will thank you this morning. Waymaker, Pastor. Hallelujah. Veronica, where's the pull up? Pull up one more time. God of the valley, the mountain. So what? So what, go on. I will not worry. God will make the way for me. This is how I want to feel all day, man. When I get down, I dismember say to myself, you are powerful and mighty. You provide all of my needs. His promises are true. God is not a man that he will lie. Hey. Anybody I call you and say, boy, with a negative thing, say, sorry, give me a second. I call you back. and you call them back with a good word. Don't ingest, imbibe any negative thing today. Just focus in on the goodness of God. It will transform your thinking. It will come out of your spirit and you feel a joy. Oh God, in His presence there is fullness of joy. I feel like preaching this morning. In him I got you. Hallelujah. I tell you. Hey, someone now want that's a wag one. But God will make a way. Hey. And we have to believe it, you know. Because if we don't believe it and we doubt it, neutralize. I will not worry. Let's continue to praise. A praise chain. Yes, man. Let's start a praise chain. Like the Veronica. A praise chain. Let's start it. Count our blessings together. You can't imagine all of us group and count the blessings. You can't imagine if everybody put for them blessings together. I will pile it in together. Oh, mighty God. Eh? Oh, my God. Hey. Oh, you find my song, Jeremy. You find my song. You find it. Anything these hands touch will prosper because God says so. Oh, mighty God. Just believe it. Mighty and power. You are in control. The God of the valley. The mountains and the sea. So I will not worry. Yeah, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, sweet fellowship, Holy Spirit. Yes, man. Yes, man. Yes, Diane. Rocking at your desk, Diane. Just rock, man. Don't feel like we just rock Diane at your desk right now. So God will make a way for you. You know, lunch today? Don't worry about it. God will make a way. But you have to believe it. Yes, man. God will make a way. Yes, Pastor. You will make a way. I know. I met the song just yesterday. I said, that's my song this morning. God will make a way. And I believe that it is your song too. You believe it too. Believe it. If you don't believe it, believe it. I tell you, if you believe it, that God will make a way for you, trust me, it will come true. He's not a man that he should lie. Let us praise him right now. Let us go to him in prayer. Father God, Holy God, righteous God, oh mighty God, Jehovah Shelek, the God of my inheritance, mighty God, I come to you this morning, Jesus Christ, who you are, the Jehovah Nisi, the Lord my banner. You are the Jehovah Jireh, who is the provider. You provide for us, Lord God. We thank you that you are the Jehovah Shalom, our peace, who give us peace. He said, the peace I give to you is not as the world give. He said, let not your heart be troubled, Lord. And we're going to stand in obedience today, Lord. And we're going to declare your truth that you are our God and you will make a way. You are the way maker, God. You are the miracle working God. We give you thanks, mighty God. We worship you. We bow down before you, Lord. Strengthen us that we can praise you in the valley. We can praise you on the mountain. We can praise you in our low times. We can praise you in our high time. We can praise you when we are going out. We can praise when we are coming in, we can give thanks just to be awake, to breathe the breath, the air that you provide for us, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. Forgive us. Forgive us when we fail and fall short, Lord, to recognize, to stop, Lord, when we don't seek you first. Forgive us, dear God. Forgive us, Lord. Cleanse us, wash us, mighty God. We come to you. He said, we can come boldly to you without reproach, mighty God. He said, you are just and faithful to forgive us if we confess our sins, Lord God. Lord, our lives, Lord, those who have received Christ, our lives have been given to you because you first gave it to us. You first loved us, and therefore we love you, Lord, for how you loved us, for how you are loving us, for how you allow us to carry on, mighty God, through this day. Lord, some of us are are down in real time. Some of us are distressed in real time. Some of us have family members who are ill, sick, near to death's bed, mighty God. But you are the God of comfort. You say, mighty God, you will comfort them in a way that only you can do, mighty God. There are people in real time right now, as I say and pray, that are in the hospitals right now in COVID-19 wards who are distressed, have nobody there. They are going insane. Mighty God, I pray the power of the Holy Spirit of God to visit, mighty God, to rescue, to cause miracles to work that would baffle the eyes, the ears of the caregivers, the care workers, the doctors, the nurses. They must say, I don't know what happened to this one, but everybody died, but he's alive. I don't know what happened to this one, but he's still breathing off the ventilator machine. I don't know what happened to this one, but he's going to declare, God, you are sovereign. You sits high and look low. And Lord God, you are providential. And therefore, we trust in you because you are worthy of our praise. You are a good God. Lord God, we know that all things, sometimes some bad thing or one that we don't understand it, Lord. We don't understand. We praise you still. Even though we don't understand it, we praise you still, God. We praise you because you are deserving. But you said, we know that all things work together for good, for the called, mighty God. We are the called according to your purpose, mighty God. And therefore, we give you thanks for your word, for your truth. We give you thanks this day, Lord God, the God of the valley, the mountain, and the sea. So I will not worry, because you will make a way for me and you and all of you who are watching. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. What a day. I give you thanks, mighty God. Have a beautiful day today, my family, my friends. I trust and hope and pray that somebody, some spirit was lifted this morning. Maybe it started down, but you are lifted up. Just refocus. Just focus up to God. Bless you all. Have a wonderful day today. Awesome day today.